Thank you. us pray. Father of heaven, we ask for your mercy and your grace to be upon the service today. That, Lord, you would be honored, that, Lord, we would again remember, Lord, a life that is so precious. Lord, to you, to this dear family, we pray that you would encourage us, Lord, to remember and reflect upon Sister Dale. We're so thankful for, Lord, her life, and, Lord, that we come and celebrate that life together today as her family comes to remember her life and the friends that have come together to celebrate her life. We're so thankful that you are the giver of life, and we thank you, Lord, for your mercy, that grace that you give. So we ask today that you'll meet with us today, that you'll be honored, and we pray this today in Jesus' name. And God's people sit together.
Amen. Amen.
You know, the Bible says that Jesus is the resurrection and the life. That's what he told to Martha, family. He told the family of Lazarus. He said, Martha, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. Believest thou this, Martha? Believest thou this, family? Believe it. Believe what Jesus said to Martha, because Jesus is the resurrection. A day such as this, do we come together to remember and to celebrate a life of Dale. We also come together today of hope, knowing that there is life after death, that Jesus has given us that hope of resurrection. So, friends that have come together today to remember Sister Dale, we come together today to celebrate Dale's life, because she was a lady of love and compassion and a lady that cared so much about others. And so together today we want to remember her life and to lift up this family. So again, you friends that have come together today, thank y'all so much. She would appreciate your presence today, all of her co-workers and those that she's acquainted with. The family wishes to thank each one for your care and your thoughts and your prayers that has been upon them. They thank you so much. So again, may we again honor Dale's life together. Listen to this song, One Day at a Time, Sweet Jesus.
I'm only human, I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway now than then.
this time, Sister Lisa's going to come and share some.
I've known you as a father.
truly believe that, Sister Dale believed that, the goodness of God. And that was instilled into her at a young age, that the goodness of God is great to look to for strength, for hope, and for stability. As I was talking with the family, they gave me some verses to look at and how wonderful it is that, I mean, some scriptures that they love. And as I pondered over one verse that they gave to me in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse number 10, I read it and I see Sister Dale in this verse. For this verse speaks about ministry, just in a broad picture of ministry. And Sister Dale had a ministry about her, as we're sharing personal remarks in a few moments, and friends will come and share personal remarks about her ministry. But the verse of Scripture in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse number 10 says, "As every man hath received the gift, even so minister the same one to another, as good stewards of the manifold grace of God." Let's pray. God, thank you for your word, and may your word encourage us today. That grace, the grace of God, that gives us strength in times such as this, that we can still celebrate and still rejoice in a life, Lord, that, Lord, you work through and live through. Lord, that we can come together and talk and share memories and love and friendships, Lord, such as Sister Dale was to so many. Lord, I pray that now you would speak to us through your word, and it will encourage us that we may lean upon that one who loved us and gave himself for us, the Lord Jesus. And it's in his name we pray this, and God's people said this. Amen. Now that verse of Scripture says, to every man that received the gift, as I thought about Sister Dale, I could give a title, be loving and helping. As to me and my wife have been around her for 4 years, and moving here to the community, meeting the Matthews family and Dale and Vita, and how precious they are to the church and our community, was a trait that I too saw in Dale's life of loving and helping others. And as I think about this verse, the first thought I bring to our attention is, as he says, as Peter brings out about the gift, that is, the special God-given abilities. As God has given all of us abilities and traits that we too can share to others, Peter is again alluding to this. The ministry in general, having a special loving heart, is a trait that Dale had. For the Bible says in John 13, verse 34, "A new commandment I give unto you, that ye love one another as I have loved you, that ye also love one another." Dale looked out of life and looked at people in a way that showed grace and loving to compassion to others. And it started from a young age of being reared and brought up in a Christian home. The second thought I bring out of this verse of Scripture, speaking about sharing what God has given, how that second part of that verse says, "Even so minister the same one to another. Hide it not in, but to share it, willing to help and to give yourself over unto somebody else." Willing to help where there is a need to be attended to. Here, Peter is again ministering to others, and he's sharing that the gift that God has given unto you, to share that gift to others and to bestow it and to encourage one another in that gift. And then the last thought I bring to our attention in that verse of Scripture is living out God's grace to others. Living it out before others. How the Bible tells us in Isaiah 40, verse 31, "But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint." You see, at times, sharing and living out God's grace, we get weary. If we're honest, we get weary because we're pouring ourselves out to people and we're giving of ourselves. And at times we too get weary when we pour out God's grace that was given unto us. And as Dale, she never met a stranger. She reached out to those that was in need of God's touch. But God's word comforts us to wait upon Him and that He would restore our strength. I love how Isaiah brings that out. It says here that He will renew our strength. He will renew those abilities that He start inside of us, and He will continually be able to give us the strength and the grace to continue helping out, living out God's grace to others. How Peter makes that statement as good stewards of the manifold grace of God. That is the extended hand and the feet that we are to be for God, extending that grace to others. Though we are weary, though we are tired at running, though we're struggling at times in life, yet there is one that we can lean upon. And just as Isaiah says, that the Lord shall. It's the Lord that gives us the grace. It's the Lord that gives us the ability to be able to share that grace that was bestowed upon us. So this afternoon, as we think about Dale's life and think about her upbringing, being brought up in a Christian home, the second child of three, Dale was given strong values. She was given values that was solid, that was sure. It was a sure home in the Matthews family. Brother Norlin, though I never met Brother Norlin, but Sister Nadine shares about her love for him, and Vita shares that same compassion. And Dale growing up, knowing those values of a Christian home, being brought up and going to church, going to Sunday school, going to Craigmont, learning the values at a young age that there was a man named Jesus that loved her, giving her life to the Lord Jesus. She again, that was instilled into her, the grace, the mercy that was given unto her. Talking to the family, that was a trait that stayed with her at a young age, that she was a lady of grace, that she would look beyond our faults, because there's not one in here that don't have one. Even the preacher that's standing before you has faults, has problems, and the only one that can give us the grace is the Lord Jesus. And she met that, and she looked beyond all of our faults, and she extended hands to those that were around her to help. But also in the value of a Christian home, she understood the value of working. It was just at Vacation Bible School that Vita was sharing with us the work ethic that she and Dale had. And that is, until the chores were done, you didn't go anywhere. You had to pick the weeds. You had to chop the corn. And I'm like, do what? Chop the, I'm talking the acres, not like just a garden, but you had to chop the crop of tobacco, top and sucker, and all of those things. They didn't have Roundup, I guess, back then like we do today. Roundup ready corn. I wish you did. But she knew the ethics of working. Even so much so that when she was coming up, she was a little older than Vita. She was 16 months older than her. She got a license before Vita did. So she had the legal right to drive a vehicle. Well, Brother Norlin wanted her to go to the store and pick up some stuff, I understand. So Vita knew how to do the stick shift of the truck, but Dale didn't. So what Dale done is she done the legal part of driving. And so at the time she appears, Vita would say, okay, and so they would shift the gear. So it was a two-part party to get to the store and then get back and bring the stuff to Brother Norlin. So she believed in a work ethic, and it carried on in her career of the healthcare and other things that she was involved with. She was a person that had patience, I understand, to be able to sit there with Sister Nadine and quilt. And I understand Vita didn't do very well with that, but Dale did. Dale liked the quilt, and she took time with her. But she also loved her daddy, and her and her daddy would go and walk and had long conversations, and she really missed that, Vita said, of not being able to walk with Brother Norlin. But she carried those same work ethics all along her life. She was a lady that was caring to and committed to her love, to
Brother Keith that had passed, and in their marriage they had some great times of camping and fishing, and she loved doing and being with them, though she did not have any children. But Caleb and Zachary, Zachary's not able to be here because his wife's about to have a baby and working with that. But she loved y'all like you were her own. She would, I understand, do things with y'all. Every minute she could, she would do stuff with y'all. Buy you things, take you places, take you fishing, camping, do whatever she could. She loved you. She loved all of her family. She knows she did not have children, but yet she treated y'all and loved y'all just like it was. You see, Dale was a lady that was always looking to help, always involved in people's lives and doing whatever she could to make a difference in society, in life. You see, she had some dear friends, and that was Tammy and Angie. Angie will share in just a few moments some very special and powerful words of their friendship. But it was a team, them three. Them three were just together this past weekend, as everyone knows. But it was special that they were celebrating a mile marker in Tammy's life. She was going to turn 60. She was the next one in line turning 60. Adele had already done that. And they were spending a weekend together, celebrating life, enjoying their time together, how wonderful that was. But yet, that was the type of person Dale was. She was involved in things that mattered to her and her ministry of showing grace and mercy to lives that some others may not look to. She was in UC in the Bulletin. She was involved in AA. And she was very involved in recovery. She was involved with Overflow and the work that was going on at Overflow and helping and outreaching ladies, women that were involved in husbands that was with substance abuse. And so she was in hands-on with trying to interact with people and to help them. I can remember just the last time that we really had a long conversation when Sister Nadine had surgery. We sat there in the waiting room together and we talked, and she was just sharing with me some things that, what was exciting, a Bible study that she was involved in, and how she was just excited about what was taking place in the recovery that she was involved with. And she loved doing that. She had a passion for that. Not everybody has that type of passion, but Dale did. She reached out to people that some may not would ever reach out to. She was compassionate about that, and she cared so much. So if I could share anything today, is that we would tap into the grace that is given to us and then transfer that grace that's been given to us to somebody else's life the way that Sister Dale did. That we would share it, that grace, that manifold grace that was given unto us. Because the Scripture tells us plainly that there's none righteous, no, not one. That we all have fallen from the grace of God. But God commended His love, and that while we were yet sinners, that Christ came and died for us to give us hope and to give us life. So I leave you, friends and family, all of these here today, with that there is grace that is given. There is grace that is given, and His name is Jesus. Father of Heaven, I pray that You take these words, Lord, that Peter gave to us, Lord, that has been shared about Sister Dale, and Lord, that You will apply them to our hearts today, and Lord, that we'll make a decision to receive that grace that is bestowed upon all mankind. And it's in Jesus I pray. God's people said,
Amen.
Amen. It's time now, Sister Angie's going to come and share.
So eloquently. I may not do it as much justice. After it happened, I sat down, wrote down memories when Rita asked me if I wanted to say anything, and I said, I'll try. So I'm going to get through as best I can. As I had said, my friends, the other celebration of life 2 days ago, this is condensing 45 plus years of friendship into a subject of her life as my friend. We met at a girlfriend's house. I don't know if any of you knew Denise Parker. She was having a party, and it was summer, right before we went to South Johnston, reporting to high school, ninth grade. Dale came up to me and started talking. That's just the way she was. We were instant friends, and we knew we were going off to South Johnston, and we sat there and talked for a while and couldn't wait to get there. I got to know the family over the summers during that time, helping them barn tobacco in the summers. You know, Matthews, they were hard workers, absolutely. We only lived about 3 miles apart from each other growing up, and my family's still in that vicinity, and they are too. I got her into some mischief, that's for sure. Dale was from a very conservative Christian family, as I was too, but I had 5 siblings, and so between 3 boys and 3 girls, we got into our own mischief, and I just wanted to share. I'd like to take some credit, as I saw it, for breaking her out into new things and to experience things as we got older. Our other best friend, Tammy Witham, who passed away with Dale, also helped with that. We had just talked about some of those good times in history while we were gathered over the weekend to celebrate early Tammy's forthcoming birthday. You see, as Pastor had said, we were all turning 60 this year, a milestone for us, a long, long time of friendship. Although we had times where there were gaps, we never saw each other because life took place, and we moved away and moved around. But after my father died in 2006, I went back in the church, and there was Tammy and Dale sitting there. And we reconnected again. But again, life took turns and did different things. We didn't see much of each other. But when I lost my husband 3 years ago, Tammy and Dale were beside me all the way, every step of the way, and my family. And that's why some of my family's here with me today, because they continued to get to know Dale, especially, and Tammy, every time they showed up when there was tragedy. But even in the fun times we try to have them there, Dale would ask me, "What are you doing this weekend?" when a holiday would come up. I said, "Well, I'm going to be up in Benson." "Really, what you doing?" And when she found out, "Can I come?" "Sure, come on by, have a meal." And Matthew and Jessica over here, my nephew and his fiance Jessica, got to know her. Matthew did some DJ, and Dale came and celebrated my mother's 80th birthday a couple years ago. And Dale's just, like everybody here knows, she's everybody's friend. She doesn't need a stranger, and that's what we loved about her and enjoyed that time. But after that happened with my husband, we decided we were going to get together every month, no matter what, give or take a week, but we did it. We made our plans, and before we would leave, except for some reason, we couldn't decide on a date after this past weekend, but we would always plan, when's our next date, what are we going to do? And we would do that. We promised that. And I'm so thankful that we've had that time and we did that. Because Dale, of course, lost Keith only 2 years ago tomorrow. And we dropped everything. We were already packed up to get with her that weekend to do something. But this happened on a Wednesday and it came early. Tammy says, "Come on, let's go." Tammy only lived 45 minutes away from me in New Bern. I lived down at the coast. They loved coming and hanging out, especially Dale. She'd get to the coast, just like Lisa had said. She was there, and she was more than welcome anytime. Lost my place. So that's what lifelong friends do for each other. They're there for each other. And it was no different on this fateful weekend, trying to celebrate birthdays ahead of time. It was our monthly gathering for all the birthdays. Dale had a heart goal. She was always thinking of others. What gift would they like? How can I be there for you? Always calling and texting to check in. Always an attentive ear. We love that about her. It never seems, my family knows, I'm an interrupter. Tammy and Dale will be going at it with something important, and I just get a distraction and say, "Excuse me, all right, are y'all ready to eat?" You know, I was always the one to button in. But they just took time to do whatever they wanted. never worried about it. But she always took the time to look her best, fix her hair, etc. I was always envious of her style and her clothing. But Dale never seemed to be in a hurry to do anything. She was on Dale time. And I say that with love and purpose. But Tandy was the mediator because Angie was like, come on, Dale, let's go. Dale's like, Tandy's like, it's okay. All right. But we loved her no matter what. Sometimes drama, yes, but friends stick together. We agreed to disagree at times, but with love, always love. Her favorite saying in a soft, matter-of-fact way was always, it's okay. Reassuring us not to worry when we felt there was something to worry about and be concerned about. It's okay. So as I greet from a longtime friend, that voice is telling me now, it's okay. I will miss her so much, like those of you here today. Rest in peace, my friend. You don't have to take the world on anymore. You don't have to wear a mask to sleep. Praise the Lord. I picked on her something awful about that with that CPAP machine. I love you. Thank you for your time, and thank you for being here.
Special words, powerful. Thank you for sharing, Sister Angie. Thank you for being there with me. Any other spoken remarks want to be shared today? Anybody want to share something from the congregation? Any friends? Yes, ma'am.
I am a neighbor of the Matthews family, and we rode the bus together, and we were all, David, Ida, and Dale were of similar age to my brother and I. I remember on the bus one day, there was some kids that were picking on Dale, and giving her a pretty hard time was two young men, and this has stuck with me my whole life. I reflect on this, and I have shared it with my own children as a lesson. Dale was not that old, maybe 9 or 10, and she told these young men, your words do not hurt me. I feel sorry for you. I will pray for you. Those were her words, and she was not even 10, maybe. And that's a lesson.
Wow, that's powerful.
It was.
Man. Yes, ma'am?
I knew Dale for a long time. We went to school together, but I was younger than she was, and then we reconnected later on in life. And Dale loved everybody she saw, and I can truly say that. She just loved everybody. And we had some really good times together. Just she would come and take care of our animals when we go out of town, and she was always willing to help, whatever it was. One time my husband had surgery, she brought food. You know, I didn't ask her to bring food; she just showed up, and that's what Dale did. She just showed up where she was needed. She was always there whenever you needed her. And you know, I've worked with Dale and a whole bunch of our co-workers are here, and just, I can hear her saying that to the child. Being at 10 years old, I could hear Dale saying that. Because she truly loved everybody she saw. And although she had her ups and downs, she never failed loving other people.
I just wanted to share that Norlin was actually my first cousin. But after he died, we adopted Nadine, and she became my first cousin. And I believe, if I'm correct, that would make Dale my second cousin. But since she invited us to all the shindigs that had food, I promoted her to first cousin. the turnip truck, but not yesterday. but Dale was so outgoing and so lovable. I tried my whole life to find one thing wrong with that girl, and it just upset me that I couldn't. We're all gonna miss her. But I'll say one last thing, and I'll sit down and hush. With parents like Nadine and Norlene Matthews, Dale would have had no excuse, and neither do you, Vita, of not being one fine lady. Amen, Jesus.
Others today. Any others? Yes, ma'am.
I gotta do it. Oh, you get first.
So, I'm adopted, and when I first saw her, she welcomed me in like any other. She was so much. She loved me like her own, and I always miss her because she was overjoyed to see that my mother had two more children. And she always would make us laugh. And she would always call my grandmother. And she would always ask to talk to us to make sure we were all right. And I always, for my 15th birthday, I wanted her to come to my quinceañera. But I know she's going to be there spiritually, even if I can't see her.
Amen. It's precious for you. Amen. Yes. Yes, you're Christian. For testimony, 60 years of testimony, came from a great upbringing. She lived it out, that mercy and grace that was given to her. May we go out and do that same. share that mercy and grace to others. Live it out. May we not look at others as they're somebody that don't deserve grace or mercy. May we look at them as Jesus looks to us, that we need grace just like they do. Any others before we close with prayer? Father, please take these words that's been shared in testimony of Dale's life. Lord, that they would make us think. Make us think about our life with you. Lord, if we are prepared to be with you, and if we are, what are we doing with the life you've given to us now? Are we willing to share things that you've given to us to others? God, help us. Lord, help us until you call us home. Though we don't understand things of life, we don't. And we're thankful, Lord, that we don't know the future of our life. But God, we ask, Lord, you would comfort. Comfort these hearts today that are grieving. Lord, let each one know that, Lord, you are, that you are present. That you are that present help in our time of need. Help us. Help us to see that today. We pray this in Jesus' name. And God's people said,
amen.
Amen. This concludes the service here. The next part will be the committal service at the devotional gardens. Please stand.